just wanna let it go for the night. That would be the best therapy for me.
Girl, don't do it. It's not worth it. I'm not gonna do it, girl. I was just thinking about it. I'm not gonna do it. I did it.
No. Ooh, maybe a little bit. Oh, I'm gonna regret that. Oh, I already hate myself.
I've heard that if you destroy your art on TikTok, then it gets on the For You page. So I just wanted to say, if you ever see me do that, you can just cancel me, because at that point, I will be...
My favorite. When you're working so hard to make a master and you get it perfect, but a fluffing moth decides to come and hang out in your resin.
So ever since I did the black marker and you guys all corrected me and said yes, it should have all the colors in it, I've kind of been obsessed with making these videos, and here you go, here's another video. Enjoy!
Money doesn't buy you happiness. Fame only puts a magnifying glass on the shit that you already have. And if that shit is fucked up, you're just gonna have even more magnified fucked up shit in situations where it doesn't even seem valid. No tiene la culpa. Amor de comprenda. Amor del pasado.
I had a lot of requests to help Peppa Pig, so I thought I would give it a go. I thought the head started out strong, and then I added the nose. And here it is, Peppa Pig. Okay, let's give this another go. So I read all your comments and I really, really tried. I really struggled with ears. I did it for way longer than I did before and the face was a struggle. Everything was a struggle, but here it is. No.
I've had a few people ask me if I've ever done a pyramid wrong and what do I do with it if I do. Now, this is a dolphin pyramid that I had to stop quite abruptly. An air bubble got trapped and created a huge crack along the side of the pyramid and the dolphin's face. Mistakes happen, but you learn from them and you move on. I can't quite bring myself to throw this one away, unfortunately, so it's just sitting on my studio desk.
You ever just do something and then realize you fucked up? So this is something I was working on to make a resin mold out of, and a little sneak peek as to what it could possibly have been. But I just realized I made it out of plasticine instead of polymer clay. And if you know what plasticine is, it doesn't harden ever. You can't make a silicone mold out of something that doesn't harden. And I just spent the last literal 36 hours on it, making it like perfect shaped and everything. Now it's gone.
Another crafting fail, you guys. I'm gonna show you guys the best crafts that I do and the worst crafts that I do. And this is how to fix one of the worst ones. So I wanted to glitter a champagne bottle for New Year's yesterday, and the glitter and the Mod Podge was just not mixing well. It looked like shit and I knew it. Some of the spots were streaky, some of them was thicker than others. So I got out my X-Acto knife before it completely dried down and I just started scraping away at it. And then once I got down to where just basically the residue is, where the Mod Podge is on the bottom, I took it over to my sink and I scrubbed it. And it came out literally as good as new.
Imagine going through your junk drawer and finding fucking googly eyes. This is why I hoard shit.
I'm going to Michael's to get bigger balls, so stay tuned.
Hey guys, I picked a white person today because I struggle with finding the undertone as well with them. So we're gonna learn together. This is like the average color scheme for undertones in most people. You should try your best to figure out what kind of undertones your reference has. There's a tool you can use on Instagram where you can like pick the color and figure out what kind it is.
Obviously the world is not as exaggerated.
I'll be using those colors and I start with the lightest color.
And so you just, you know, build up your layers or whatever, shadows. I went wrong when I started adding. I added too much blue because I didn't realize how pigmented it was. And so like I had to keep adding more warm colors and I kind of fixed it and like it'll look better when I do the color pencil, but that's basically what I do.
Okay, so I've gotten a couple of the same question on my last few posts. One of the big ones is, what do I do when I mess up? It's really unfortunate because a lot of time with resin, having to let it set overnight, you don't even realize that you've messed up or that it hasn't come out the way you wanted until you wake up and unmold it. And you're like, crap. And it sucks. And it's really unfortunate. But the biggest thing is just kind of, you know, seeing how you can make the best of it. So for instance, I use this piece as an example. Because I am not a huge fan of how the first piece came out, the full moon. But I did really like how the other moon phases came out. So instead of scrapping the whole thing, I just went ahead and made a new full moon. trust me, it's very different with pyramids. Like, if I mess up a pyramid, like, that's kind of super frustrating. But yeah.
Top 8 things that no one tells you when you become an artist. Random bursts of energy at 3 in the morning are common. Like, I drew all of this. Do I remember it? No. Sometimes your art will go from looking like this on one page to whatever this is. It's terrifying, I know. Oh, anatomy? Yeah, we don't know her here. Your markers can and will run out at the worst possible times. Sketchbooks. You'll have a lot of them. Sometimes you'll be drawing something, and it'll look amazing. Then you'll just happen to go look over your air conditioner for a second, and then bam, it looks like that now. Your old art. Oh, we don't talk about that. And finally, the absolute worst thing you will deal with as an artist. Can you draw me?
I found these packet of Pokemon cards at the Dollar Tree, so I got a bunch. And while looking at them, I saw this adorable one and I want it on a case. So I'm going to make a silicone case with it right there. I added rhinestones. I'm going to add flat back pearls on the side and then purple silicone, and I'll show the process, well, little by little. Okay, I added pearls all around. Now I'm just gonna glue this guy onto here. Bam. So here's my silicone. I'm just gonna add some purple. Oh, hopefully that's not too much. And mix and put it in a piping bag. I failed and now I'm so upset. I quit. Ah! I'm so sad. This is the cutest Pokemon. I can't save it.
You guys have been very supportive of my mistakes, so let's go through my bin of mistakes and I'll show you how these guys ended up here.
The pigment didn't stick. It should look more like this.
These guys both have splitting headache. This happened a lot with these guys because they use rubbing alcohol to clean the surface to give the pigment a smooth finish. Sometimes it dries too fast and it cracks. You got a super cute face, but a dirty bum bum. This one is the wrong color. It just fell in a pot of pigment. It's supposed to look like this, but it fell right into this pot. These guys got a lot of issues. I let my husband paint the eyes, though they're a little squidgy, and then they fell on the ground, and some of them cracked or touched other wet people. I thought maybe x-rays would be cool, because this design was pretty cool. I don't think this was the move. This one is a disaster. I don't know what happened here. Like, what was even the point? I think I just got this and I wanted to try it out. Just squirt it onto somebody's head. See what happened. No, it was a bad idea. You got a little bit too much glue there, babe. I experimented with washes and it looks like poop. This guy fell off a plate after we put sealant on him. Ew, you did this to her. When you try a new eyeshadow and it gets everywhere.